If a Jew become rich, is a very bad sign. Most of the time, it's bad for him. I'll tell you why. The Torah said in Parashat Vayetchanan, Ani Elkana, I am a street god, Meshalem LaRasha El Panav LaAvido. When I see a Jew that is 90% sins, 10% mitzvot, what am I going to do? I have to pay him for the 10% mitzvot. I have to pay him. Where will I pay him? I don't want him in heaven forever. So I have to pay him in this world. So I have to give him many millions of dollars. Another 10 million, another 5 million, another 2 million. I'm paying him in this world. Why I pay him so much? Because I don't want anything to do with him once he died. I don't want him with me. So I'm paying him la'avido. Meshalem la'rasha. Pay the reward to the rasha in order for him to get rid of him. Lo acher leshalem lo. I will not delay the payment of the wicked person. I will pay him right away that I don't have anything to do with him later. So what do we learn from this in the Torah?
In the
Torah, it's a verse in the last three verses in Parashat Vayetchanan. No rabbis, no Gemara, no Zohar. In the text of the Torah. Ani El, I am the zealous God who pay the wicked cash to their face to get rid of them. I will not postpone their payment. I will pay them right away to destroy them. This is a verse in the Torah. What does it say about the tzaddik? It says, Meshalem le'ohavai, I pay my lovers, le'shomrei mitzvotai, that keep my mitzvot, le'elef dor, for thousands of generations, to the righteous. So what do we learn from the Torah? Very simple. You don't have to be a genius. It's simple Hebrew. The ones that Hashem love, He put almost all the reward for the afterlife. Why? Because it's much bigger, gigantic, and eternal. And He gives them what they need in this world. The one that He hates, He gives them for whatever mitzvot they did. They give some donation, they keep some mitzvot. Even the biggest wicked person does some mitzvot. No, he has mezuzah. One time he participated in Brit Milah. He did Brit Milah for his children. He did some mitzvot. So Hashem gave him $50, $100 million. He gives him everything. He has a dream. He wants to own a baseball team. So he allows him. He wants to buy this building. He wins. All kinds of things. Give him a pretty wife. His son became a lawyer. All his dreams come through. And Hashem says, I'm done with you. I paid you for all the good you did. Now you have nothing. You come naked. So therefore, if you see somebody wicked, only growing and making and everything works for him, he's the only most miserable person. However, sometimes righteous people, Hashem also give them a lot of money. Why? Because He wants them to have an opportunity to triple their reward. You should know one thing that most rabbis don't say. Most rabbis don't want to put the highlight on money too much. Why? Because they don't want the wicked people to take advantage on what I'm about to say. But Hashem said it. So if Hashem said it, it means He's not worried about it. What does Hashem say? Hashem say, Gadol ha-me'aseh yoter min ha-oseh. When a Jew makes other Jews make mitzvot, his reward is greater than them. So that means if I convince one of you now to do mitzvah that you never did, tomorrow you do it, Hashem will give you full reward for your mitzvah, and I will get a little more than you, doing nothing, just convincing you, giving you a CD, whatever. Now, if I came and I gave you a few hundred CDs here today, somebody paid for it. I cannot pay for 20,000 CDs every month for my pocket, no. So if it costs $1, and somebody gave $400 or $500 and sponsored the CD, and the CD is traveling from Jew to Jew, from car to car, all over the world, and Jews becoming religious, all the mitzvot they will keep from then on, thanks to his CDs, goes all to his account. So from here we learn something very interesting. We must keep mitzvot, we don't have a choice. But all the mitzvot we're going to keep, for the 70, 80 years we're going to live, it's not even 1% of how much our money can make to us. So in other words, if you see a modern Orthodox person that keep very, very little. It's not strict. Shabbat, barely. Kosher, barely. Torah, barely. But he gives tons of tzedakah. He can make more mitzvot than the biggest holy rabbi that you know in the world. He comes in Shamayim. He's in a higher level. Why? He gave millions of dollars, and his money made thousands of Jews religious. Since they made billions of mitzvot for him, he is better than the chief rabbi of Israel. Because of his money. That's why rich people that don't give tzedakah, they'll kill themselves when they die. How stupid they were, burning their money on nonsense, when they could have bought billions of mitzvot easy with their money. And by the way, it doesn't cost millions to buy mitzvot. A person can make from thousands of dollars that he gives, he can make millions of mitzvot every month to his account. Remember this. If a person sponsors 1,000 CDs and he goes to 1,000 Jews and each one of them would hear 30 hours of lecture, $1,000. Most people here make it in a day or in an hour. You know, in this town, I know people who make millions of dollars every month. Knowing them personally, I know how much they make. They ask, sometimes they call, I made that deal, I made $12 million. How long, how much you worked on a deal? 2 weeks. In 2 weeks, he made $12 million. So how much from that he will give tzedakah? $1,800. Wow. That's what happened. Why not 5-6 million? 1,800 he will give. Why? Because he's not clever. If he makes so much money, he should have given more than half of his money to make more and more and more. One day he died, he has more mitzvot than Moshe Rabbeinu. Why? Even Moshe could not make thousands of people religious like this in his time. Everyone was religious. He only taught them Torah. But you take a person that is a goy and you made him Shomer Shabbat, and one he puts his children in yeshivot, and then he has grandchildren, and grandchildren, and grandchildren, and grand... You have trillions of mitzvot. For what? Doing nothing. Just like... And what happened in the end? The people died, and who takes their money? America. Obama. Uncle Sam will take the money. So you rather leave the money to Obama than making your brothers religious? This is it. So this is an example how a person can have the opportunity, but he missed the opportunity either from stupidity or from yetzer hara or from just not thinking. Thank you very much for staying so long.
Thank you.
It turned into a marathon. We'll see you again, I have a feeling.